The return or the unbanning of the Oromo people and the return from exile of their leaders back to Eritrea is a very, very significant development in terms of, you know, lasting peace for the people of Eritrea, but indeed also for the entire region. And I believe that the current prime minister has actually shown not only courage, but uncommon leadership in actually unbanning them from being a terrorist group and, you know, creating a table, making a space for them on the political table of negotiation in Eritrea. So, yes, it is a very significant development. Mm-hmm.
Tell us more about the Oromo Liberation Front, the group that he leads.
The group that he leads actually came to being sometime around 1971-1973, but more as a political group. Now, there were quite a lot of, you know, resentment of the group, even though, and that is the irony of this whole, you know, issue, even though they represent the majority in terms of ethnic divisions in Eritrea, the Oromo people actually were more repressed than the minority group, which is, you know, the opposite of what you see in other parts of the world. Now, the Oromo people themselves are actually a very, very, you know, significant ethnic group in Africa, of course, occupying, you know, major part of Eritrea, but spilling over to places like Kenya and so on and so forth. Now, with all the turmoils, the political turmoils, they were, you know, they resorted to armed struggle, blowing up, you know, places and partaking in a number of, you know, terrorist activities, to the extent that they were indeed declared a terrorist organization. The rest is history, because a good number of them were driven into exile, and from the exile, they continued to operate, you know, to give voice to the people of Oromo. Mm-hmm. And today, their dream appears to have come true, that of return back to their country and being part of the political development.